Matthew Teutimez is the tribal biologist for the Gabrieleño-Kizh tribe. Using his background in science, Teutimez has learned to modernize traditional medicines to treat himself and others.
So I'm one of the fortunate ones in our tribe that was able to attain a bachelor's of science in biology, as well as my master's. But for me, my true education came in with my uncle, who taught me the traditional knowledge about our plants and our animals, and taught me the uses and the benefits in terms of taking the science and the tradition and putting them together to make sense. And what that made me realize is that science is only now documenting what our families have always known for eons and eons. One of the main concepts that my uncle teaches us is how the plants and the animals are actually created before us. They were put on this earth prior to humans. Therefore, they are older than us. They are our elders. Our elders are meant to teach us. I unfortunately was born with a genetic disorder called hemophilia. And that disorder throughout my lifetime has caused a lot of pain. I was getting overwhelmed. So I'm taking thousands of milligrams of ibuprofen, of Tylenol. These were very toxic to my inner organs, mainly my liver, my kidneys. It was actually literally killing me. That detriment led me to go to my uncle and say, hey, you know, are there any plants that I can use that will help me? And so he then took me out and started showing me all the different plants. And I was familiar with these plants already. I just didn't know their capacities. Our native plants work locally, where they only go to the spot that is hurting, because that's where you apply it, and they do not have to go through your organs and do damage as they're going through. Without my uncle providing that traditional medicine knowledge, the ecological knowledge that our tribe still has, that information would have been lost, and I would still be taking Tylenol and ibuprofen and potentially not talking to you today. It was that serious.
Teutimez grows plants at several local gardens to educate the public about the plants their tribe uses traditionally.
So do you want to tell me a little bit about the plants here?
I would love to. Today we're here at the Homestead Museum, a beautiful location that has actually planted native varieties here that give an example of many of the different native plants that we have here, and a lot of them are medicinal plants. This particular guy is one of our favorites. This one is willow. And so also willow has a high amount of a compound within just its new growth of salicin. And salicin is a very, very useful compound. And that's the same compound that's on the wart remover, same compound that's within the active ingredients of aspirin. All of these medicines that we readily use today, all were derived from this plant.
While at the Homestead Museum, we sat down with Andy Salas, the tribal chairman of the Kizh Nation. He told us the tribe was named for their dome-style huts made of willow.
The history of our tribe goes back thousands and thousands of years. Us personally, our tribe, our nation, we go back, it's estimated 12,000 years, but we, like grandma and grandpa, we said it goes back further. We're the DNA to this area.
So what did it mean for you guys when the Spanish came and started the mission system? How did that make California tribes different?
Well, when the Spanish arrived here, it was basically the beginning of the end for our people. We thought, you know, as the oral history goes, is our ancestors believed that they were gods of some kind, but it was it turned in more later, I would say, into a nightmare. The sorrow that I have behind the mission is the atrocities that happened there pertaining to my ancestors.
And the Gabrieleño-Kizh tribe isn't federally recognized yet.
No.
Tell me what that means for you and for your father.
I didn't even introduce my father. My father is Ernie Perez Teutimez Salas. He's our chief, he's our spiritual leader of our tribe, and through him, we have a rich history. We're the foundation of California history here in Southern California, in this LA Basin. I mean, we're the direct descendants of this area, and we have everything to prove it, but yet we still struggle for that federal recognition.
Despite the tribe not being federally recognized, they still help the government protect the land. In 2018, Teutimez became the first member of a non-federally recognized tribe to be elected to the California Environmental Protection Agency's Tribal Advisory Committee. The committee helps CalEPA look at issues with an indigenous perspective. Teutimez has advised on projects like putting fish back in the LA River and helping the state reach its air quality goal of zero emissions.
So, in our capacity of being on the Tribal Advisory Council with California EPA, we get to meet with different boards, departments, organizations, and discuss a lot of the strategies that they are utilizing to help clean up our environment. And one of those particular meetings was with the Air Resources Board. And during this meeting, they were describing to us how they're going to create these little sensors. And so I'm thinking, hold on, do they know about black sage? So this plant right here is black sage. For environmental purposes, what we're finding out is that because this plant is so sensitive to many of our toxic compounds that are being emitted by many of our vehicles and our machines that are going on in our environment, it can be used as an indicator of the air quality. And so our plants have so many capacities to them, because when we go back to our story of the willow, it's about those relationships, and not just our relationships with humans, it's our relationships with those that have also been given the breath of life. And that's these guys. And that's what's important.